Having trouble remembering all those rules for taking derivatives? In this video, we'll try to help you by giving you examples to remember them by. Whenever an abstract mathematical formula arises, you want to think of a concrete example which illustrates the formula. It's a good exercise to try to come up with your own examples. Let us start with the most basic rule of calculation: multiplying a function by a constant. Consider a car on a roller coaster and let us measure the distance it has traveled in meters as a function of time measured in seconds. The derivative of this function is the speed in meters per second. If we change the unit of distance to feet, we know that there are 3.3 feet in a meter, so the number of feet traveled is 3.3 times the number of meters traveled. Likewise, the number of feet per second is 3.3 times the number of meters per second. This illustrates that the derivative of a constant times a function equals that constant times the derivative of the function. We can also see this visually if we look at the graph of f. The graph of 2f has a slope twice as high as that of f. Next, we consider the addition rule by looking at someone walking in a moving train. The speed of the boy with respect to the track equals the sum of the speed of the train and his walking speed. That is, the derivative of f plus g equals f prime plus g prime. The product rule, sometimes also called Leibniz's rule, is the first of the two most important rules of calculation. Consider a pyramid. If we take a cross section at a distance x from the top, we obtain a rectangle with width wx and length lx, depending on this distance x. The area of the rectangle is the product wx times l of x. Let us now consider the derivative of this area, which is the rate at which the area increases if we look a little further down the pyramid. Having x increase to x plus delta x increases both the width and the length. The extra area can be split in three parts. The yellow part equals the width times the change in length. The green part is the length times the change in width. And the small purple rectangle is the change in length times the change in width. Now, observe that the change in width is approximately the derivative of the width times delta x. And similarly for the change in length. We can use this to calculate the area of the three rectangles. If we now look at the rate, we see that the derivative of the area equals the width times the derivative of the length, plus the length times the derivative of the width. The limit of the area of this small purple rectangle becomes small as delta x goes to zero, even after dividing this area by delta x. Thus, if the change in height tends to zero, it does not contribute to the derivative. As an example of how to use this rule, we now calculate the derivative of x squared times sine of x. This equals the derivative of x squared times sine of x plus x squared times the derivative of sine of x, which is equal to 2x sine of x plus x squared times cosine of x. In this video, we have illustrated the following three rules of calculation. Multiplying a function by a constant multiplies the derivative by the same constant. The addition rule tells you that the derivative of a sum is the sum of the derivatives, and the product rule gives the derivative of the product f times g as f times g prime plus f prime times g. In the next video, we will have a look at the chain rule. See you there.